Good morning, Senator Harris and fellow members of the AB 394 Technical Advisory Committee. For the record, I am Andy Haven, Mayor of the City of Henderson, and it's an honor to be here today presenting. I look forward to sharing with you the information that we have gathered about parental involvement in education and the role of community engagement in our Clark County schools. Our goal was to hear from both Henderson parents with children attending our public schools and from members of the community. In order to do so, we utilized several outreach tools. First was an extensive online survey divided into two parts. One part was open to parents of current Henderson students enrolled in grades K through 12, and the other was open to anyone who wanted to share their point of view. I'm very pleased to say that we had more than 700 individuals take part in the online survey, which was active from March 3rd to March 20th. I will be discussing the findings from both the parents and community members surveyed in greater detail a bit later in my presentation. We were also aware that other communities around Clark County have utilized our survey as an outreach tool, and we are anxious to hear about their results today as well. The second tool we utilized was a series of focus groups with Henderson parents that were meant to ensure that we were reaching out to a broad-based section of our community. These group conversations lasted 2 hours and were done with a small number of participants in a roundtable setting. Those taking part were asked in-depth questions and encouraged to share their thoughts and opinions as parents about the issue of involvement in their own children's education. There were a total of 5 focus groups conducted over 2 separate days. One of the focus groups was comprised solely of African American parents with children currently enrolled in Henderson Public Schools. 2 other focus groups were conducted to help gauge the sentiments of the Henderson Hispanic community, one in Spanish and one in English. The 2 remaining focus groups were comprised of Henderson parents with a variety of different backgrounds. I will be highlighting some of what was shared in these focus groups, along with specific comments from participants on the topic of parental involvement in education during the second half of my presentation. Now I'd like to go back and walk you through some specifics of the online survey. Excuse me. When asked about their interest in the issue, the number one answer among all participants was they have a child in public school. The number 2 was that they shared a concern of how public funds are spent in education. And the 3rd most popular response was that the individual said he or she was a concerned citizen. I think this speaks to the wide interest in our community about education that encompasses more than just parents of students. The next 2 questions asked were about the things that parents like most and least about their schools. As a reminder, the answers going forward are only from those who identified themselves as parents with kids in Henderson classrooms. The survey found that they liked the teachers in the classroom most, and 2nd was the surrounding neighborhood next to the school. The lowest ranked answer on the list of things that they liked about their school was school board leadership. On the list of things they dislike about their school, overcrowded classrooms and high student to teacher ratio was number 1, followed by curriculum and school board leadership. The next question asked about the most important factors in a child's success in school. The top answer was quality of teachers, but the 2nd highest ranked answer was parental involvement, which in the survey was referred to as parent support / participation. When asked only about the specific issue, do you think parental involvement is important to your child's performance in school? The answer was an overwhelming yes, with 97% of parents agreeing with its importance. We are pleased to learn that in Henderson, a majority of us said they are able to participate as much as they would like in their child's education, with 63% saying that was in fact the case. However, 1/3 said no, and I hope we can explore ways to ensure parents have that chance to be involved. On a similar note, 72% of parents also said they felt that they had the resources needed to participate effectively in their child's school's life. Question 11 asked parents to write in answers about what would make it easier or more meaningful for them to be involved in their child's education. They generally fall in five different categories. First, communication. General comments requesting better, more effective, and more frequent communication from the school and teachers to parents. Second, grading, requesting timely updates of the online grading system, Infinite Campus. It's hard to keep students accountable and respond to problems when grades are posted weeks or months late. Number three, homework, requesting timely updates of the online systems for assignments with sufficient notice in advance. It's hard to keep students accountable and respond to problems when assignments are not posted in a timely fashion. Fourth, technology, requesting better use of technology in general and better use of social media to send out information. And fifth, work scheduling, requesting accommodations for working parents to participate after working hours for PTA/PTO meetings and other events. This next question asked about the Parent Teacher Association or parent teacher organizations. 43% of those who responded said they did not participate, while 37% said they were active. I hope we can encourage more parents to be part of these groups and address the issues with work schedules and other commitments that prevent them from taking part. While they may not be the only barrier to participating, those work-related conflicts were raised in the previous write-in responses and were also periodically mentioned in other open-ended comments in our survey. Next, we asked about sharing information to see if there are ways that parental involvement is impacted by the ability to receive updates, invitations, and feedback from their student's school. The survey found that email was the best way to communicate, with 88% choosing that as a preferred method, followed by text, phone calls, website, and Facebook. Another question we asked was, how do parents become involved when they learn that there is an issue with how their child is behaving or performing in school? A combined 80% said they either met with, called, or emailed the teacher principal, while 36% said they talked directly with the child. And if a parent feels there are conditions in their child's school that they want to complain about, how do they become involved? Where do they turn? 60% went directly to the teacher/principal, 20% went to the CCSD administration, and 12% went to me as mayor, my elected colleagues on the city council, or the staff at the city of Henderson. Next, we asked parents to choose from a list of topics that they are likely to participate in related to their student's school and curriculum. At the top of the list was curriculum, followed by performance of teachers/principals, budget, choice of principal, and textbooks. I would ask you to pay close attention to this next question, as it corresponds with this day's examination of institutions like site-based councils, which give parents a role in decision-making at the local school level. When asked how parents could be more formally represented in decision-making, nearly 70% of the respondents said through participation in a community group that provides direction to the school on key decisions. I believe this finding is a good indicator of support for a reorganization model that includes direct parent participation in school decision making. The parents we surveyed also felt that schools could do more to give them a way to participate or to receive information in cases where they could not attend a meeting or event related to their child's education. The next 12 questions in our online survey were open to all community members, not just parents of CCSD students. When asked about the best way to get their opinion on topics related to schools and education, more than 80% said they liked online surveys, followed by attending a community workshop or meeting, and third most popular, talking to the teacher. One of the key components of community engagement is making sure that individuals have more information about how they can become involved. We asked those taking the online survey where they go to find out about community meetings or events. The slide now on the screen contains some of the top answers, which include Facebook, school, City of Henderson, email, news. We also ask respondents who are the community leaders they turn to for information, and what to see on the screen, what you see now on the screen is a visual representation of some of the top answers given. One of the issues we hear identified repeatedly in survey comments is the difficulty many people experience in attending school meetings and other education-related activities because of jobs and family commitments. Here are some of the factors that community members say make it easier for them to take part. 80% said have the meetings at a convenient time. 65% said make sure it's in a convenient location. And more than 40%, that means host it at their local school. Henderson residents see a role for the city to play when it comes to supporting educations and school in our community. Two-thirds say that city should be finding ways to attract funding to enhance schools and to provide more programs for kids where they live. 60% say the city can play a strong role in building relationships between schools and community partners. And 50% say the city should help establish community-based groups that provide a way for residents to influence decisions related to schools and youth programs. Next, we ask what improvements could make a neighborhood a better place for children to learn. The top answer was more activities for kids. The second most popular answer was expand SafeKey and other city-provided wraparound services. And third was expand programs at libraries and community centers for kids. I'm pleased to report that the next question again shows that engagement is already a priority for many in Henderson, with the survey results showing that school events are the number one activity that residents participate to improve the community. One of the questions that is often raised is what role members of the community who are not parents can play in supporting education. We asked what skills could community members contribute or volunteer to their neighborhood schools. Nearly 80% said mentor students and provide knowledge of other skills. More than 70% said volunteer in the school. And more than 60% said share real-life job skills, tutor students, read with students to help them improve their skills, or allow businesses to sponsor educational programs. On the next question, nearly 80% of those surveyed said the local businesses should be involved in financial or volunteer partnerships with neighborhood schools. I find this result particularly encouraging as our survey was in the field at the same time that the Las Vegas Metro Chamber and Las Vegas Global Economic Alliance were hosting the Be Engaged or Business Education Engaged Summit. This event encourages local businesses to take more of an active role in supporting education, and it is clear our community wants that as well. Another popular idea is to ensure schools promote community engagement separately from parental engagement, an idea supported 2-to-1 by poll participants. Football, basketball, dance, theater, our public schools in Clark County are filled with talented student athletes and performers, and they draw crowds to events. Our survey found that 80% of participants said they attended supporting events or performances at their neighborhood school or at other schools in Southern Nevada. And the answer from 9 out of 10 respondents was also an overwhelming yes when asked, do you feel these sporting events or performances are important for fostering community engagement? Our final two questions focused on how community members could be more directly engaged in school decision making. The first asked if they would like to be part of a council that provides direction to local schools on key decisions. Nearly 55% said yes, they would like to be involved. And the next question asked what decisions they would like to help make. 85% answered curriculum. 70% wanted to help with budget decisions. More than 60% want input on teacher/principal performance. And more than half want a say on the selection of a school principal and input on textbooks used in classrooms. For the focus groups, As I discussed at the beginning of my presentation, we also convened 5 focus groups to gather additional information on the question of parental involvement. All those who participated are parents with children in Henderson Public Schools. These focus groups were a way for us to gather input from people who may not typically participate in surveys or public meetings, including those for whom there may be a language barrier or challenges in taking time away from work, childcare duties, and other responsibilities. Now for the good news. A majority of those who participated in our focus groups were women, and there is no question about the critical role moms play in child's education. We found that parents in our focus groups were highly engaged, able to participate in their child's education, and felt they had resources needed to support their child's success in school. We also found that when asked, "What does parental involvement mean to you?" moms and dads viewed their involvement in 2 ways. First was through the school, which included attending events and meetings, volunteering in the classrooms, fundraising, and other activities. The second type of parental involvement was through the daily interaction with their children, including reading to them, helping with homework, limiting television, and reviewing assignments. Participants consider this involvement as key to their child's success in school. One parent said, quote, "Parental involvement includes helping in the classroom, assisting with fundraiser, school events, etc." Another commented, "It starts with supervising the homework that comes home in the homework folder and making sure they're doing all of it." Another added, "It includes volunteer activities to help the teachers and the school. For example, in reading, in math, in their learning." One parent shared, "Reading and doing things together with the children." Another commented, "I go to the open house to meet the teachers and to learn their expectations." And there was this statement, "We just received a notice asking for donations. They don't have uniforms. They don't have materials for their activities. I took the initiative to ask for donations in my community, and I was able to raise $2,000 for their uniforms." Along with this point of view, "You can be involved as much as you want to be. After a certain age, I'm able to step back to build confidence, touching base where there is a problem." And this final thought, excuse me, "There is a difference between the size of the school and the impact that the PTA has. Once they go into middle school and the size of the school gets bigger, the impact of the PTA seems to diminish." We also asked focus group participants to share ways to improve parental engagement. Here are some of the suggestions. Offer a variety of options for meeting times, locations, and events. Participants requested morning and evening options for CCSD and school-specific meetings and events and wanted to attend a Henderson location. Provide more adequate notice of upcoming meetings. Provide access to computers for families who don't have them at home for homework and communications. When families lack access to a computer or a printer in their home, it limits the ability to help with homework and school projects and can be a barrier in receiving communications from CCSD through the web and email. Ensure communication is accessible for families who might not, whose first language may not be English, and recognize that if a parent is challenged because they have a low level of proficiency with English or technology, it can severely limit their ability to be actively involved in their own child's education. Consider providing childcare for siblings. Parents in our focus groups are told siblings are not allowed to attend school activities. For some families with small children, this means parents cannot volunteer in the classroom or attend school events. We are grateful to all those who took the time to complete our online survey and to the parents who gave generously of their time to be a part of our 5 focus groups. When looking at the findings from both, there are important lessons that we can learn about parental involvement and community engagement. First, parents want to be an active part of their child's success in school. Both our survey and focus groups showed that they are active in their kids' education now and anxious to find ways to stay involved. This includes being part of a decision-making at the school level, which is something that is being discussed as part of our look at ways to reorganize the Clark County School District. And this includes wanting a say in budget decisions and in evaluating how principals and teachers perform. This is important to keep in mind during discussions about the potential creation of local school councils that could include parents and community members. And our survey also shows that the members of the community in Henderson and other parts of the valley also want to be engaged in improving our schools, whether through volunteering, to share their skills in a classroom, supporting athletics and performing arts, by attending events, or serving on a board that brings together educators, parents, and community members to give impact on important decisions made about schools that impact educational success. Thank you again for the opportunity to present today, Senator Harris, and I look forward to answering any questions from you or other members of the Technical Advisory Committee.
Thank you. Do we have questions from members of the committee? My goodness, you've stunned us all. Oh, Councilwoman Scow.
Thank you. Very thorough and wonderful presentation. I just wanted to ask, did the focus group members do the survey also?
I believe they did, David, right? Yes.
So they took the survey. Was there a difference? Was there a noted difference between the focus group results and the general response? Just curious.
I'm not sure of that.
Richard Derrick, the City of Henderson Chief Financial Officer. They were invited to take the survey as well, and so they should have. But basically, the focus groups used the same questions and it's got deeper. And so really, they were exploring and had more open-ended opportunities for the members to actually give us the feedback back. Sometimes with a survey instrument, since it's only one-sided, we're collecting information. There's not that two-way communication. And the focus groups actually allowed us to go a little bit deeper. The themes were very similar. And so we actually have a kind of a thematic report from those focus groups, but they align very well with the survey.
Thank you. Any additional questions? Mr. Velardita?
Thank you for your presentation. I'm looking at a couple of slides. You don't have these numbered, so it'll be a little challenging for me to guide you to them. But one of them says, what topics are you most likely to participate in related to your school child's or your child's school and education? And it says almost 70% is the curriculum, and then almost 63% is the input on teacher and principal performance. And then later in your presentation, when asked feedback from parents, what decisions would you be likely to participate in related to education in the schools? Again, 80% plus is curriculum. And then the closest one after that is almost 70% budget decisions for the school. Now, when asked what role the city of Henderson should play, your slide says, help attract funding to enhance schools and provide more programs for youth in the neighborhoods where they live. And then strengthen the relationship between schools and community partners. So I guess on the one hand, what I'm getting from this is parents are saying curriculum and student and principal performance in terms of their involvement in decision-making at the school. But the role the city would play is one of, attracting more funding and then strengthening the relationships in the community. So I guess I'm just curious, what do you glean from that in terms of the role the city plays juxtaposed against what parents say they should be playing?
Well, I think personally, Madam Chair, through you, I think personally what that's telling us is that parents really want to be involved with the curriculum and with their principals and their teachers, but they understand that on the funding side, that's not something that they really have the ability to do, that they have to look to government for that. And I think, and there still is some confusion, not a lot, but some confusion about exactly where fundings for schools come from. There are some that still believe that the city of Henderson actually has an active part in that funding. And of course, most everybody knows that the tax, property taxes, is where funding for schools come from. So I think that's what I was pointing more at, was they realize that government has to fulfill that obligation of funding the schools.
Thank you. Dr. Young.
Thank you for your presentation.
Thank you.
One of the questions I have, I thought you did a very, your team did a very good job in terms of laying things out. But one of the questions I have is, did you break any of this information out by, at the very beginning, I'm sorry, let me just go back. At the very beginning, you have five focus groups, and yet you have your other surveys. Did you break it out by demographics, say for African Americans, for Latinos, for your other various cultural groups, in response to both the focus group as well as your survey, and then to do any kind of a cross correlation between the responses between both?
The short answer to that is yes, we did do. We did do that.
Is that listed here? Is that listed here?
For the record, Javier Trujillo, Director of Public Affairs. It's not listed in presentation, but we do have that information.
Oh, okay. Thank you. I would just be interested in.
Okay.
All right. Mr. Rodriguez.
Thank you.
Yeah, first of all, congratulations. This is a great report. A lot of information to digest. I guess what I'm wondering, Mayor, and your staff, you know, you mentioned how this might impact the reorganization. And I guess I'm wondering, since you guys put it together and you've had time to really think about it, how would this information work in a reorganization? What do you see in terms of reorganization?
I think whatever we do with this reorganization is that we really have to make sure that we have parental involvement in decision making. I mean, that came out loud and clear on this. And so however we do this, we want to make sure that on the neighborhood or the local level, if you will, that there is that input.
Thank you. Any other questions from members of the committee? I'm going to ask a question, then we'll get back to you, Councilwoman, okay? When you asked your questions of your focus group and also with regard to your survey, was there a question or any thought put into asking parents that were involved or maybe not involved at all, if they would like to be more involved than they were presently engaging in their child's school, and if so, what that would look like for them? I understand the comment from the childcare perspective. You know, that sounds to me like there's at least one family that would like to be more involved, but because of requirements and responsibilities at home, they're not able to engage like they'd like to. So I'm just kind of curious if you've got data that would suggest or not suggest that there are parents who are not satisfied with their present level of participation and would like to find more ways to participate.
Well, I think part of that goes back to I believe there was one third of the parents felt like that they weren't engaged or they didn't have that ability to be engaged. So we do have to work on that. On the other part of whether parents felt like that they could do more or if there was an opportunity for them to do more, I'm not sure that we asked that specific question, but I think overall the survey results show that parents are pretty well happy with their involvement with their own child in school, and then also with the parents and the teacher, the principals and the teachers.
Thank you. Councilwoman.
Thank you, Madam Chair. A question occurred to me as some of the other questions were being asked. Were these open-ended questions, or was it more of a multiple choice? The answers were offered.
I would say on the focus group it was more open-ended because you had that ability to be engaged that way. But on the other surveys, it really was A, B, C, or D.
Okay.
There were choices, not necessarily letter, but there were choices that were given.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any final questions from members of the committee? Seeing none, City of Henderson, you're excused.